Good morning. Merry seventh day of Christmas and Happy New Year tomorrow. My name is Pastor Joyce Emery, and it's my privilege to welcome each one of you in the sanctuary and those that have joined us online this morning for this service of worship at Eastwoods Presbyterian Church. We're so glad you're here. I hope you've had a wonderful week of celebrating Christmas. Maybe things slowed down a little bit for you so you could just relax and bask in the gift of a Savior given for each of us. We are a congregation committed to celebrating this Jesus and connecting with and caring for all people. We want you to read the bulletin. If there are mistakes, it's totally my fault because Julie was on vacation this week and she set things up so I could finish the bulletin. So it's my fault, but it was sort of fun doing the bulletin. So please take that sign off and fill it out and pass it during the offering plate. Today we get to have a chili supper together after worship, so please plan to stay and fellowship. We will be celebrating the gifts of Carson Dunn, who's been serving with us as our interim music worship leader since June 15th. And so it was June 15th, Carson. And so he has given so much time and energy. So we will have a time of prayer at the end of the service, and then we want you to stay. Vicky's gotten his favorite cake so that we can all eat cake together as we end the year. So please plan to stay. And I believe that Pastor Curtis and some of the teenage, Kimbrough, and some of the teenage boys from Unity Family will be joining us. So I give them a special welcome. They wanted to say thank you too. Tomorrow evening, we're redefining who young adults are at this church, but you are welcome to join Keith Bloss and myself, who will be hosting dinner and a time of sharing gifts and just a wonderful time of singing. Keith, we can sing and it'll be wonderful. So please join us, but let us know if you're coming. I'm making lasagna and I want to make sure that you have a piece. So let us know if you're coming. And then next Sunday after worship, Keith Michelatos, a friend of mine from previous ministry settings, will be here. I think he's bringing his whole family, so be nice to them. Just kidding. Matt will be here to talk about his life and his inspiration. He's a fascinating person, an influencer in this day and age with young adults and people of all ages, especially, well, new believers. And so he has fascinating stories to tell. So come and meet Matt and hear his stories. I believe that those are all the announcements now. So let's, instead of a sermon, we're going to have a song sing today. So you need to get your hymn books out and choose a favorite hymn, a first and a second verse that you'd like us to sing. You can choose anything in the hymn book, but for contemporary praise, we have listed 10 songs in your bulletin that we are ready to lead. So nothing else will be allowed. These are the only ones. So hymn book is open, but these are the only ones. So we hope that we'll have a wonderful time of singing God's praises together during this service of worship. So let us silence our hearts and center our minds as we prepare to worship, and I light the Christ candle. Please join me in prayer. O gracious and holy God, you are the God of every season and every day and year. As the years flow by, as seasons end and new beginnings come, we thank you that you are the guide of every day. And so we offer this worship to you and ourselves to you, As we reflect on this past year, we ask that you would give us eyes to see where you were present, not where there was trouble, but where you were present, holding on to us, carrying us, leading us forward. And give us eyes of hope and love and joy as we look forward to the new year, where you are King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and the possibilities are endless. Oh God, we know that you see the pain in our world, and you see the places where the body of Christ is alive and well. We pray that you see us as a body of Christ, ready to be your people in this time. So we offer this service, our life together, to you. In Jesus' holy name, amen. Please stand as you are able for the call to worship. We have welcomed the Christ child and declared the glory of God's salvation that comes to live among us. And yet still, we wait. We watch and work for God's reign on earth as it is in heaven. We prepare to welcome a new year, thankful for how God has brought us through the past year and anxious to discover what the new year might bring. We watch and work for God's reign on earth as it is in heaven. We join generations of Simeons and Annas who learned and taught us how to listen, notice, and discern divine love at work in the world. Come, let us listen as we live in anticipation of God's reign on earth as it is in heaven. We join in singing hymn number 28. Good Christian friends, rejoice. Each one of us has our story of salvation, where God met us and loved us and forgave us. Our ongoing life is a process of being saved, of always confessing and always being forgiven and renewed. So let us pray first together in unison and then in silence. God of stars and angels, God of sheep and lambs, God of abundance and grace, you know us well, better than we know ourselves. You hear us cry Gloria and praise, and you watch us tear things apart with our words and deeds. You hear us say, Thy will be done, and use me, O God. And you watch us do nothing in response to cries for help. You know us, you love us, and you forgive us. Hear us now say, help us to change, turn us around, make us more loving and courageous and hopeful. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Friends, who is in a position to condemn us? Not our partners, our spouses, our children, only Christ. And Christ died for us. Christ rose for us. Christ reigns in power for us. And Christ prays for us. Therefore, believe the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Because we are forgiven, we are called through the grace of Christ to forgive others. And we do that and we experience peace. And so we claim that peace as we stand and greet one another saying, the peace of Christ be with you and also with you.
Tobias, is this on? Great. Okay. I'm Dave Sauerberry. I'm one of the deacons here at Eastwoods, and it is my pleasure this morning to deliver the children's sermon. So if there are children out there viewing us, good to see you all. Just in case there's some in here, good to see you all. We happen to all be children of our Lord, however, and so this is a sermon that is directed to children of all ages, even as old as some of us. We get to all be kids today. And so given that, as kind of the background, let me read a few things to you if I can. Did you guys get everything you wanted for Christmas? Christmas morning, did you look under the tree at all the presents and were filled with excitement over what may be inside? And did you, like my grandkids, did you open each one of them, set it aside, and expectantly wanted to open the next one because you kept going for that next present and that next present? Or did your parents and grandparents have that rule, like we did too, where you got to open one present at a time, and it was the only way that you could move forward when that one person finished opening their present and the next person got to open their present? And that made the waiting almost unbearable. So if you had that rule, you know how that felt, right? My granddaughter Molly, who's 9, literally vibrated waiting for the other people in the room to open her presents. So, know how that went. And as parents and grandparents, did you get everything you wanted too? Did you reflect on your role as an elder in your family? Or perhaps a guide for the young ones in your lives? Have you ever wondered in your life if your life and your continued existence has meaning? A legacy, if you will. Or are you more of the mind just to kind of hang on and play out the string? Many of us got to celebrate Christmas with family in all the chaos and laughter and joy and contentment that came with it. Did you gaze out upon your family gathering like I did and feel blessed and comforted and praised God for the opportunity to share these fleeting, precious moments with those around you? Did you get an unexpected gift? Did you? I did. And as it turns out, it's as precious a thing as I've ever received. Let me tell you about it. So Annie and I, we've both been married before. And our family is a yours, mine, and ours family. And so 3 daughters, one's Annie's, one's mine, and one's ours. And our eldest daughter, Tanya, Annie's daughter, but she's mine. She ended up, her dad had a son by another woman. And he ended up growing up to be one of the most fabulous young men you've ever met. And he currently moved up here into Vancouver to be closer to Tanya, our daughter. And he ended up adopting our family, Annie and me, and our family. Now, this sounds really convoluted because when's the last time you heard that the parents of the ex-wife of, I can't even get it right, took on raising the family of her ex-husband? But we did. They adopted us, we adopted them, and it was the most amazing thing that you could imagine. They went on to have a son, Zaid. I don't know how to spell that, but Zaid is his name. And they let us know that we were going to be the quote adopted grandparents when we got a t-shirt one day, and the t-shirt said, "Can I call you granddad?" Yeah, that's pretty special. Wow. They've become quite literally family for us. They're not blood. Blood isn't family. Christ makes family. The Holy Spirit makes family. We have family. Anyway, I got this present from them. Let me tell you about it. This is probably a replica of an old compass. And the compass, on the outside of the compass, I know it's difficult for you guys to see, but the outside of the compass says, God will always guide you. God will always guide a compass. God will always guide you. Inside the compass. Dave, never underestimate the difference you've made and the lives you touch each and every day. And there's the compass. Pastor started the service this morning by talking about the fact that we are guided by our Lord and we walk the paths that He set for us, but each one of us needs a compass. That compass is our faith. And my family presented me the most precious gift that I believe I've ever gotten, and yet tears flowed. They do that to me. Dear friends, we've got the obligation and hopefully the opportunity to share our lives, our stories, our joys, our disappointments, our longings, and most importantly, our faith journey with our families. Don't wait. Don't wait. And to the kids sitting here, if there were any, and watching on video, and I hope they are, if you have the blessing of having older people in your lives, reach out to them, talk to them, listen to them, hear their stories, and wait for them to finish. They'll enrich your lives beyond measure, and you may not know it right then, but wait for it. For they are some of your best faith guides that you'll ever meet. As we were guided by the Lord throughout Advent, we waited for His birth. And Christmas morning, our joy was complete. The wait was over. But a week later, maybe a bit of post-Christmas letdown crept into your lives. So here's something to consider. Perhaps it's time to reflect on the best presents you did get this Christmas, possibly my compass here. But I don't really mean the material ones. I mean the time that you guys got to spend with family, whatever that looks like for you. Worshiping with friends, remembering loved ones no longer with us, reliving old traditions, and maybe even making some new ones. I believe at the very top of our list of our presents is knowing that our Savior is alive and well, and that the anticipation and the fun of waiting on Him during Advent and the promises His birth brings to our lives is our most precious and longed-for gift. And sometimes we get a gift like I got, an old compass with the Lord pointing the way, prepared for me. That's the path that I'm on, and being cheered on by a loving family, and that means everything to me. So you know, receiving just the right gift, the most precious gift, the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ, makes the wait worth it. And as His children, we are loved by our Lord and guided by His gentle hand, and as we wait and receive His gift of salvation, it's okay to vibrate like Molly did, with anticipation and excitement, for the journey continues. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank You so much for the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. We got to spend Advent waiting for Him, and now it's time to continue the journey on and use our faith as our compass and use the path that You've laid in front of us, for You are our compass and our guide. In Christ's name we pray today. Amen.
Good morning, friends. As members of the body of Christ, we are called to care for each other at all times, whether it is a time of rejoicing, giving thanks, praising God over good news, or lifting each other up before our Lord during difficult times of hurting, grieving, or feeling lost emotionally. Let's be in prayer together before our Lord. Great God, we rejoice in Your presence among us. We come to bow with the shepherds, to kneel with the wise men, to adore with Joseph, to hold You in our hearts with Mary. Let Your church proclaim Your glory and Your love. We pray for the ministers of the word and the shepherds of Your flock, for all who go out in mission, for all involved in outreach. May we reveal you as the light to lighten all peoples. Lord, we remember with sadness the divisions of our world, a world not at peace, where people are misused and often scorned. We remember the places of war and violence. Lord, may the nations come to know the peace which only you can give. We pray that we can learn to live together in harmony and fellowship. Lord, we give thanks for family life, for our homes, and for those who have cared for us and those we care for. We pray for children who are not wanted or who are denied love, for all children taken into care, for those abandoned, the abused, and the ill-treated. Lord, we remember all who are lonely this Christmas time, all who are troubled or sad, all who are unable to enter into the fullness of joy through sickness or bereavement. We pray for parents anxious about their children. We remember and pray for all who are in need of healing or comfort. Lord, we remember all who have entered into the joy and peace and the glory of your kingdom. May they rejoice in your presence and your love. Lord, we ask that you continue to bless this congregation as one year ends and a new year begins. Help each of us to be your light in our community and offer support to those inside and outside our church walls. Bless our work done through Family Promise and SEDEPCA and grow our connections in our community. True light of the world, who lightens all, shine in our lives. Please be in prayer for our brothers and sisters listed in the bulletin, and we ask you to also bless those we now name before you and also in the silence of our hearts. Into your hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray, in the name of the one who reconciled all creation to himself, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Brothers and sisters, let us join together in the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Good morning. I'm Jackie Tyler, the elder for missions. As the year draws to a close, I want to thank you for contributing your time and your talent, your treasure to all the organizations that we support: Family Promise, SEDEPCA, Friends of the Carpenter, and the Prayer Shawl Ministry. We could not continue to support these groups without your efforts. Thank you. If the ushers will come forward, I'll pray for the offering. Please pray with me. All good gifts come from you, dear Lord. And from these riches, we bring this offering. Help us to use it for the furtherance of your purpose in this place and for the benefit of those in need. Amen.
Thank you.
Next Sunday, I'm going to begin a sermon series during the season of Epiphany called Signs and Wonders. And the passage that I am reading today, I'm going to preach on. I love this passage. So you'll hear it again. So from Luke chapter 2, beginning in verse 22. When the time came for their purification according to the law of Moses, they brought Jesus up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male shall be designated as holy to the Lord. And they offered a sacrifice according to what is stated in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. I bet he was quaking with excitement. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace, according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people Israel." And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for the falling and the rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." There was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was of a great age, having lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage, then as a widow to the age of 84. She never left the temple, but worshiped there with fasting and prayer night and day. At that moment, she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child to all who were looking for the redemption of Jerusalem. And when they had finished everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. And the child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So let us then sing the gospel to one another as you choose your hymns and spiritual songs. Ron, host our songs this morning.
Yes, we're going to be singing songs of the season. And so it's any of the songs of this particular season. And it's going to be one that you will be calling out a number. I know that could be a bit chaotic, but that's okay. There also is a list in your bulletin that has some of the contemporary songs that have sung. The others are songs that you pick out of the hymnal and call out a number for. Okay? So, is there a first hymn?
403?
Right. Thank you. What a friend we have in Jesus. 339. Be thou my vision. What a wonderful one for the new year.
Thank you.
Assurance, Jesus is mine.
I'm
have? That's the one. Okay. Well, we say it.
Built my life.
Built my life. Thank you.
We'll come back to you, Tim. Father's will.
Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you all for bringing your voices and your spirits to praise God as we end this year. And thank you to each one of you for the music that you share. And especially Carson, who I want to have come right down here and stand. And any of you that would like to come forward and lay hands on Carson, I would invite you to do so at this time. Carson was raised in this congregation, as some of you know. His family raised him here to love Jesus, and he went away to college, got married right here, right where that big X is. Came back, had a good job teaching in a private Christian school, and at this point in his life has been a substitute teaching up at the Battleground School District and working for us and giving so many hours to help us praise God. And now he's heading off to WSU for a master's degree in education so that he can be certified to teach in any school district in the world. Right, Carson? But to be a witness for Christ. And so I invite you as you're led to pray for Carson, and then I will close. Lord, hear our prayers. Holy gracious Father, we know that the standing grandparents are online. And they would want us to pray for all the love that they've had for Carson over the years, and that you would continue to hold his heart and make him strong for you. And now, God, please anoint him again and again with your Holy Spirit, that every classroom he steps into, your light will radiate through him. And that he will have the eyes to see each one that comes before him with your eyes of love and grace and mercy. For, oh God, we are all on a journey, and we need people like Carson to guide us. And so thank you for equipping this man for your service. So we commit him to your ways, and we ask that you would bless this meal we're about to partake. May it nourish us not only with laughter and fun, but good cake and time, as we celebrate all the stories of this past year and the years gone by. And we prepare our hearts for what lies ahead. We want to be strong and faithful and courageous, oh God, for there is so much evil and darkness in the world, and we will not be daunted. We will not be held back. We will move forward by the grace and the power of your Spirit. And so we claim that in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen.
How about a big round of applause?